Unfortunately, nobody got hurt. These guys in the truck, they saw it coming. He tried to avoid it, but just couldn't get out of the way fast enough.
It could have been a lot worse. I mean, that's like pretty darn close to that.
Yeah. Yeah, it could have. You know, you think that he made it through downtown. Getting in a pursuit like that, there's a lot of risk that comes with that activity. We're weighing the risk versus the reward throughout the whole thing. You go into downtown, if things had not been ideal, I'm certain that the commanders would have called it off. You know, this everything just kind of came together well today.
Well, and I mean, Sergeant Wade was kind of hinting at us too, like before we knew he was in custody, like a little nerve-wracking to see how this was going to end. Is that, I mean, obviously we had a crash, but we have everyone safe and the guy in custody.
Did he have weapons on him?
I don't know what he had on him when they took him into custody, and we haven't searched the car yet. So, I mean, there was an indicator that he had a gun at one of the last robberies, so, you know, it's high likelihood. Now, what were you talking about with Wade said?
That this could have ended way differently.
Yeah, well, and that's one of our concerns when these things happen is when people start getting so erratic like this and absolute disregard not only for what appears to be, you know, witnesses seeing them and the risk of getting captured, we wonder what their behavior is going to be like at the end. It's usually, you know, it's usually pretty bad. He did some very bizarre things. You know, jumping down on the freeway shows that he really doesn't care much about himself, and, you know, we have to follow. So, yeah, this is probably the best outcome we could expect given the circumstances today.